Have you received a lot of attention after this article was printed in the Smithsonian Magazine? Are you getting quite a bit of feedback because of this?
I am. I've been very fortunate in that regard as well. Everything has been very positive, and I've been contacted by a number of different groups throughout the United States. And it's been very good. I think it's important to continue to celebrate the knowledge that we gain through public universities, especially land-grant institutions like Texas A&M, and how we're committed to trying to solve issues, real-world issues today. So while we do a lot of basic research at a place like Texas A&M, we're always looking for applied outcomes. And I think that's something that needs to be celebrated across our country.
Let me ask you this. Maybe I'm simplifying this too much, but at what point in the work and the research did you all sit around at the table and say, oh, you know what, we're tired of mosquitoes. I was getting bit last night. This is what we want to do. This is what we accomplish.
Well, I think that's where, for us at least, we have a really dynamic research group from a lot of different disciplines. So we're always trying to think outside the box. We're always trying to think of how we can take our technology or our research to the next level and see what the universal principles are. And that's what we're finding, is that this concept applies across most animal model systems. So for us, we're just in an environment, thankfully, at a place like Texas A&M, where they allow us to be creative.
So what do you do with this information from here? Where do you get to the point where we are able to use this in our population and in our society to actually have an enjoyable evening in our backyards without the mosquitoes flying around?
Well, there's a couple different paths that we see that might be viable moving forward, and I'll give you a couple options here. So one of the ideas is that we may be able to develop a wipe that a person could use on their skin that could either disrupt the communication of the bacteria on your skin without killing it or harming it, or that may release a deceptive message to the mosquito population. So one idea is to come up with a wipe. Another idea might be to develop a trapping system where we have mosquitoes become attracted to a site to lay their eggs, thinking it's a good location when in fact it's not. So there's a lot of different paths we can go. The main thing we're trying to do is develop green technology, and that is the idea that instead of putting insecticides or repellents on your skin that could be quite harmful to your bacteria, that these compounds would not have such an effect.
Where do you do all the testing? Do you have a facility here in College Station that you put these theories to test, or do you do it somewhere else?
Texas A&M has done a very nice job of setting me up with the infrastructure to do a lot of this research, and they continue to invest in helping me develop my lab so that I can do this work. But it can't all be done in my lab. So my lab, in conjunction with Dr. Craig Coates in the main entomology building, as well as with Dr. Tawny Crippen at USDA and with Dr. Tom Wood at Penn State University. So a lot of it's in different labs. So we do a lot of model testing in different labs, and then we bring it together to do the overall test of the concept. And that work was done within the Department of Entomology.
We want to thank Dr. Tomberlin for his time. Now, if you want to read more on this, we've linked a couple of articles on our website at kbtx.com. Just click on First News at 4.